Hi, my name is David. I am responsible for this course in prototype realization. This course is the second stage of a project spanning over two courses. We started this spring in a course doing aircraft conceptual design. The students were divided into groups, and each group was allowed to choose between three different design topics. Those were to create a UAV for humanitarian aid, or a single seat twin engine jet aircraft, like a luxury sports jet, based on two Swedish turbines. And the third option was to design an electric powered tow plane for glider aircrafts. Now, in this project, the prototype realization, we are now taking the designs that we did in the previous course, we are shrinking them down, and we are building a physical prototype, a flying prototype. We're doing this using modern prototyping tools, such as laser cutting, 3D printer, and CNC machines. So the students get to work a lot with CAD and prepare their production material. We then create the parts and the students assemble them. Lastly, we finalize the aircraft and we take them into a test flight. And that's the funny part. That's when the students get to see how well their designs worked or didn't work. So in the end of this course, we arrange one big flight event where all the groups and all the projects are taken out to the airfield and we fly them. And this year we had 8 teams and 8 projects. I'm really happy to say that all of the 8 got airborne. At least 7 of them landed safely. Only one of them landed a bit scarred, but that's part of the learning process. And that, from my point of view, is just as much of a success as the ones that landed safely, because it's a learning process. At this stage in the education, the students they've done their bachelor's, they are in the end of the master's, so they've studied theory for many, many years. In this course, we take all those theory and we translated it into practice. So it's meant to be fun, but also in a really educative and pragmatic way.
Thank you.